Long ago in algebra class, we learned to factor things like x squared minus y squared. We saw that this is a difference of squares, that you could factor this as x plus y times x minus y. And just as a little bit of a refresher, you can multiply these two together and verify that you get x squared minus y squared. In fact, let's just do that for fun. X times x is x squared. X times negative y is negative xy. Y times x is positive xy. And then y times negative y is minus y squared. These two middle terms cancel out, and you're left with x squared minus y squared. What I want to tackle in this video is something that we didn't know how to factor before, and that's the sum of squares. So if we were to factor x, let me do this in a brighter color. If we wanted to try to factor x squared plus y squared, before we knew about imaginary numbers, complex numbers, we didn't know how to factor this. But now that we do, what I want to try to do, and I encourage you actually to pause the video and try to do it before me, is to try to express this as a difference of squares using the imaginary unit I. So let's try to do this. So the first we want to write is the difference of squares. So x squared, we can just keep as x squared. But now I want to write this part. I want to write the second part right over here as subtracting a square. So I want to subtract a square. So we could write this part as subtracting negative y squared. Obviously, subtract a negative. That's the same thing as adding. Now, how does this help us? Well, this is the same thing as subtracting negative 1 times y squared. Now, what is, if we wanted to write this whole thing as a square, if we wanted to write this whole thing as a square, how would we do it? Well, we have y squared, and what's negative 1 the square of? Well, we know, by definition, negative 1 is equal to I squared, or that I squared is equal to negative 1. So let's rewrite it that way. So this is going to be equal to x squared minus, instead of negative 1, I'll write that as I squared minus I squared y squared. All I did is I replaced this negative 1 with an I squared. And now this is interesting. And I think you see where this is going, but I'll just make it very explicit. This is now x squared minus iy squared. And just like that, using I've been able to write this sum of squares as a difference of squares. And now we can factor it just the exact same way that we factored this original expression. This thing is going to be equal to, so it's going to be equal to x plus this thing, iy, x plus iy, times x minus iy, x minus iy. And we can verify that if you multiply these two expressions together, you're going to get x squared plus y squared. Let's do that. X times x is x squared. X times negative iy is negative ixy. And then iy times x is positive ixy. And then finally, let me do this in a color I'm not using yet. Finally, iy times negative iy is equal to negative I squared y squared. Now, these middle two terms cancel out. I squared is negative 1. And so we have x squared minus negative 1 y squared. So this is subtracting a negative, the same thing as adding a positive. And so this simplifies to x squared plus y squared. So hopefully this now gives you an appreciation of using the complex, the imaginary unit I, how you can actually factor this expression into essentially the product of two complex numbers.